Alright, morning everybody, thanks for watching. I'm going to try and make us a little video here outlining the differences between the Yakima HighRoller and the Yakima FrontLoader. I've had the HighRoller for about a year and I'm replacing them both with FrontLoaders. The HighRoller is purported to be the best of the front-loading style where you do not have to take the front tire off for your bikes. I actually feel otherwise and that's why I'm getting rid of them and going with the front loader instead. So first thing, I'll give you a little preview of what they look like. These are the high rollers. And you can see they've got kind of a solid side body to them. Nice beefy look. And these are both front loaders. So you can see that the tray is skeletonized, thinner, but still a pretty nice looking piece. One of the things that I am a fan of on the high roller versus the front loader is this push button. So when I raise this up, it clicks in and I can drop it down by just relieving the tension a little and pushing that red button and the whole thing can drop back down. Whereas with the front loader, you see that it pivots on that screw, and so once I snug it up to tighten my bike in, to drop it back down, I have to spin it all the way loose. It does stop itself, and then I can drop it down. So not a big deal, but not quite as convenient as the push button. They both have locks built in, so you can lock your bike up. One of the things I also like about the front loader is you can lock it to the vehicle, where with the high roller, it technically locks to the vehicle because a piece of plastic goes over here, and that's after you've put it on. So you would not be able to remove the bike from, you wouldn't be able to remove the rack from the vehicle without popping that plastic off, but it would be pretty easy to do. I know all these locks are kind of keeping honest people honest, but this seems a little weak to me. I purchased the high roller because it was supposed to be the best. Like I said at the beginning, I don't necessarily think that's the case. So let me show you the main reason why I'm not a fan of the high roller. Those are all the parts that are needed to install the high roller onto your vehicle. The front loader comes out of the box, ready to install on round, square, or aero bars with no attachments needed. The high roller, on the other hand, comes set up for round or square bars. And if you have a vehicle that has aero bars on it, you need to buy separate clips to be able to even mount it. Okay, so I'm going to start by showing you the front loader, my new one. It is the most popular style from Yakima, so even though the high roller is supposedly their better model, they do sell more of this one, and I think for good reason. So you notice it's going on to, this is a Subaru Outback, so it's got factory crossbars. Fits onto square, round, and almost all factory and aero bars right out of the box. So we're going to lock this in. Just slide that forward. And then we're going to spin this guy. Kind of center it. That snugs the front end. Adjust the back for our crossbar width. Okay, and that's basically it. It's on the vehicle, it's ready to go. You can set these straps up either way, so I would usually use this one on the other side. That way you've got access to the release mechanism on the outside. You can just slide this down, pop the end off, turn it around, pop the end back on, and you've got it set up for either side. And then as far as the front tire goes, you can make some adjustments here at the top for your actual tire size. And then when you roll your bike in, it's gonna flip this lever up and pinch itself. And then you're just gonna snug this down. All right, now for comparison purposes, I'm gonna show you how the high roller goes on, and this is one of the main reasons that I'm getting rid of it. It's just this huge pain. First of all, I have 9 parts that I need to put this thing on my vehicle. I also have to use 2 of these with the nut in and 1 without. And because of the way it's set up, I actually have to install it backwards. I cannot put it on my vehicle in the forward direction. So these guys are flat on the one side, and then the bolt's gonna go down through there and bite into the nut. That's on the front side, so those two bolts need to have nuts on them. And this one is the hollow, so it's gonna go on the rear. It's gonna bite in with this guy. So we've got a bolt and a big nut. And then the other end is gonna get these, which I've already put the bolt into the head. And we're gonna finish it with that piece. So let me grab the rack. All right, so there's the rack. It is a decent amount heavier. And you've got this solid plate on the bottom, and that's actually what we're going to be doing, is mounting that plate onto these guys. So we have to line up those holes, and you can see why you couldn't do this in the reverse direction. If you were to put it forward with these guys, this, they go that way on the rack, it would put the tongue hanging off, and the entire rack would basically be sitting off your bar. It would all be resting on just the tab, just the very end. Let's see if I can show you. So it would all be resting just on the very end of that tab instead of on the bar itself. So then we've got that tab in place. This bolt's gonna drop down through there, and we're gonna snug it up. In the back, we've got to drop this bolt into a slot, slide it up to where we need it, drop it down all the way through, and then attempting to not scratch your vehicle's roof too much, put that T-nut into there and snug it up. Now, on the front end, we would have 2 of these, and we would need to do the bolt on the other side. But for demonstration purposes, I can show you the way it works at this point. So you're beginning to see the hassle here. There's also a left and a right, so you have to make sure that you have the right ones to go the right way. The first one I grabbed would be for the other side. So I've got this one now. It's gonna sit into that tray, so it's easiest to put it on. Drop this one into this tray, and then we can pop this guy onto there. It's still not on all the way. Let's see if this'll... You beginning to see why I don't like this one? So they have plastic tabs on the bottom. I also worry about putting this thing on and off all the time, that those are going to eventually get brittle and break. And once it's on there, you can see this one's sitting in the tray. When you open this, it's gonna sit in that tray. When I now raise this up, you can hear it catching. So it'll stay in that position, which is nice. You don't have to do as much threading on this arm compared to the front loader. And if you recall, you can push that button, relieve the pressure, push the button, and drop it all the way back down. So get it up there, snug the bike up, and you're basically done. And this is that plastic piece that's preventing somebody from stealing it because they can't get up under there to get the bolt loose to take it off the vehicle. But they could pretty easily just pop this piece of plastic, break that piece of plastic right off of there if they chose to. One, two. So for two high rollers, that's 18 individual parts plus the two racks themselves. So essentially it's 10 pieces that you need to keep track of for each one. That, in my opinion, is the biggest disadvantage of this rack, in addition to the extra $20 that you're going to pay for it. And if you're putting it onto an aero bar, something like $40 to get yourself clips set up for it. One thing that I should say is, if you're leaving this rack on your vehicle or a trailer or something all the time, then it might actually be worth considering. It does have a couple nice features, makes it a little easier to open and close, and I think it does have a little bit sleeker look to it. But if you are putting your racks on and off on an at all regular basis like I do, you're going to find this thing to be a huge pain, and in my opinion, it's probably only going to be a matter of time before one or more of these parts either breaks or goes missing. The Highroller here, 209 is MSRP on it, and the front loader over there is 189. So yeah, if you know you have round bars, you know you want to carry a heavy bike, you're just really into the looks, then maybe go with the Highroller. If you want it to come right out of the box ready to go, be much easier to put on and off, don't have to deal with a bunch of parts that you can end up losing or buying additional parts to put it onto an aero bar, I would definitely recommend the front loader. Or if your vehicle's set up with a hitch, you might want to seriously consider a tray rack. In my opinion, the best one on the market right now, Thule's T2 Pro.